have to go into the doctor to get my knee drained. It's really swollen. So that'll help my knee a little bit, which is nice.
Devil.
But I gotta figure out what the hell's going on.
Clever, devil.
It's probably the prednisone withdrawal, so I think going back to the 10 is probably best.
How quickly they do sell their soul for the feast and the promise of gold.
You guys are gonna bop around with me. Then I gotta pick up my groceries. I might have to ask my friend Kayla to help me with my groceries. She can. Walking is not good. It hasn't been like the last couple weeks. Admitting that, it makes me want to cry, actually. But things are just really difficult right now. They really are. I'm just in so much pain. It's kind of why I don't care about getting this coffee right now. I've been really good about not drinking coffee. I don't really crave it right now. But I figure I'm out and I'm in hella pain right now, so whatever. The coffee doesn't cause this much. I know it's the yogurt. it's the dairy in the yogurt. It's milk. Milk has more lactose in it. Sugar fucks with me so bad. And people are always like, drink kefir or kefir. That stuff fucks with me too. I don't know why. But I think some coconut yogurt would be the best bet. But I have my knee draining tomorrow. I feel better doing it, like, after the course of antibiotics, I guess. And, then next week I have my bone scan. So, I just gotta tough it out for November. You know, the prednisone is not adding anything good. And I've kind of redirected the idea of my diet. I'm gonna start the morning with a couple hard-boiled eggs. And then, have a tuna lettuce wrap, or like a burger lettuce wrap for lunch, and then my smoothie for dinner. I'm just lacking protein heavily, and I know that that's a big part of being able to heal your body is fueling it properly. And I've been talking about this, how like the elimination diet, I've been doing it for so long. People are like, oh, you need to do the elimination diet. I've been doing that for like literally 10 years. And then when something triggers me, I go back to like the basics. And sometimes that helps, sometimes it makes things flare more. And that's where I wonder if over time I've just been malnourishing myself. Like, I'm very thin. It's hard for me to gain weight right now because of it. And I used to gain weight pretty normally. Yeah, for Jess? Yeah. Okay. I have to get gas too. I don't love that.
Hello. Hi. So we didn't have the hazelnut shot.
That's okay. Just coconut's fine. Yeah. Thank you. That's so funny because I was thinking earlier, I was like, one time when I came in, they didn't do it because they didn't have a hazelnut shot, and that's fine. I'm not picky. But I was literally thinking about that earlier, that situation earlier. I wonder if I manifested that. That's the dilemma that I'm running into. I use ChatGPT a lot because there's a depth of conversation that I need that doesn't really feel like a lot of people can give. And that's not anything bad. It's just the experiences I'm going through. It's difficult. So my main thing that I'm having difficulty with right now. This is such a nice truck in front of me. What is it? It looks like a Toyota TR something. Oh, it's so nice. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah. Anyway, it's very nice. The thing that I have issues with is people will say, you know, take your mind off the pain, and when your thoughts create your reality. And I try to be like, I'm not in pain. I try to meditate like, I'm not in pain. Thank you so much. Have a good one. You too. That looks like a lot of cream. And I love cream. Why is there a milk jug out here? I'm just gonna park here. Oh my god. I don't know what this person is doing. Fucking freaking me out. That's what they're doing. Fucking idiots. Should have had their blinker on. Anyway, this looks like a lot of cream. Whatever. Sometimes I get extra cream in it anyway, so I'm not too mad about that. But, you know, they say your thoughts create your reality, right? I'm in so much pain, and I try not to let that infiltrate my reality, right? I try not to let that be the thought of the day. I'm in so much pain, you know? And I've been trying to trade the pain for gratitude. Like, I'm grateful that, you know, this means I still have working limbs, and they're able to tell me that something's wrong and stuff like that, you know? And I'm grateful that my body is very intuitively connected to food and stuff, to where, like, I can eat something and know immediately just how bad it is because how it affects my body, kind of thing. almost willing to bet they did not do half decaf. But that's okay. It's like 2 p.m. I guess we'll just have a long night. I need to make money for my car payment. Bills have been tight. I think I'm like $200 away from my car payment, so that's due tomorrow. If you're gonna help out with that, link in my bio. I'm struggling. But we're gonna go back in the mode, and I'm trying to show up in ways that I can, like, as if I already have money. That's what I'm trying to practice this month, is just showing up, even if it's imperfectly, right? So, that's what I'm trying to do. I'll be on YouTube later and TikTok. But I hope to have a new photo shoot this week. I have some ideas in mind of like ways I can do it while still my body can't really pose as well as I used to because my joints. I know it's been going on for so long, but it's temporary. I just have to figure out the right ratio. And unfortunately, this prednisone that I'm on is worse for me than anything. And you can't just stop taking it. You have to decrease off of it. So it's frustrating. It really is. Because I tried to stop taking it, but then the next day I had like a hella high fever. I couldn't move. My body was like just seized up. And joints swollen. Everything. Tomorrow my doctor is going to discuss options for a caregiver with me, which I don't love that. But it will help a lot. Because I don't really do much in my home. My dogs aren't like crazy, reckless, like, you know. So really the most I need help with is like grocery runs, putting it in the fridge, cleaning, and even then, like, I try to clean up after myself, so like on the way, so that it's, when you walk into my home, like, you would never be like, oh, it needs to be cleaned. It doesn't look messy. Like, there would be little tufts of dog fur everywhere. I don't think people would mind that because they see 4 dogs and they're like, oh, that's a given. But for me, every other day I like to have that vacuumed up because otherwise it accumulates a lot. I like to mop a lot because the dogs, they walk on the floor, you know, their little paw pads, and they have glands and stuff in there. So I try to keep the floors clean, bacteria and everything, and make sure I clean with certain products as well on the floors. In dog zones is what I call them. In my zones, it's fine to use certain ingredients, not ones that are toxic, you know, to dogs at all, but like I prefer more vinegar kind of stuff for floors, and I just let it sit there on the floor. I do a heavy layer of like a natural soap and vinegar. What do you call it? Like when you mix vinegar with water, something like that. Whatever you want to call that solution. I don't know. I do a Swiffer and just pour water on the floor and let it sit. Because I've heard that you need to let it sit on there for a while to sanitize it. So the dogs are really good about avoiding areas that need to be dried and stuff like that. God damn it. I don't like that I have to get gas soon because my hip hurts really bad and it's going to be difficult. Unless there's going to be like a handicap one, but for some reason the QTs don't seem to have handicap, like, help for gas. Every time I go, I don't see anything that, like, I could press a button or something to call help for. But I told myself until Thanksgiving, keep it strong. Like coffee once in a while is okay, not every day. But I've been drinking this like caramely cocoa. I love it. So my next week I'm gonna try hard boiled some eggs. I love hard boiled eggs, so, and those are easy to go for when you're hungry. So just some hard boiled eggs in the morning, and then lettuce tuna wrap, and then a smoothie at night. And although that's still a little bit under, little by little I can work my way up. My joints just aren't in the place to be doing more. So if I had a caregiver, then I probably could eat a lot better. Because my meals are pretty easy. And I could literally just ask my caregiver, which I probably would prefer. I prefer a lady, so it's probably going to be a her. But I'd prefer the person to just do it easy. I prefer the person to be a girl, but I'd like if the person could do the simple things like boiling the eggs. Maybe, on Patreon. I keep trying to wait till I have new stuff. I don't. I'm going to work on finishing my photo shoot this week, so I will have. And I'm like, maybe my photo shoot will take a week. Maybe I can do one photo shoot a week, and it will take the week, but that's okay. You know, I'm used to being able to do it in a day. So maybe I just got to take a little bit longer. It's just frustrating because on my scooter, setting up like the lighting and everything and trying to adjust the camera when you're not physically able to really do much, it's difficult. Because, like, you know, someone wants to adjust the camera, they just walk over to it. I can barely walk, so just getting over to it is an obstacle and a half, you know? So, but if I slow things down and take my time and I'm okay with that, then I will still be able to get it done. And I just want to get it done. I don't want to let this stop me from making money, doing the creative things, making content. I love making content. And funny enough, I was job bouncing a lot, but this is the longest that I've stuck to something. So that's how I know that I'd stick to my restaurant. For a bit, I was worried because my ADHD, like, what if I just end up abandoning ship, you know? Because I don't do that with a lot of my stuff, but jobs especially, yeah. If it doesn't, I've learned from an early age, if it doesn't make me happy, there's no point in for me to do it. I'm dopamine driven because of ADHD, so it makes it a lot better for me, and I am a better worker or doer at whatever it is. Because I have interest in it. Okay, oh shit. So, at this point, doing things that I love is important, and it's leading me, I feel like, down good things, and although I'm struggling right now, I've been struggling, but I'm trying to find the meaning in the struggle. I'm trying to learn, you know, I'm not trying to be like, oh, woe is me, but damn, it sucks. It does. But it just makes me want to commit to my diet even more and hopefully getting more protein into my diet and some more veggies will help. And I'll start feeling better. Because I notice when I eat more outside of my realm, I actually feel better. But then something tanks because I think usually I end up relying on medicine during that time, and that's what gets the infection going. So, hopefully going this route is a good route. But the thing is, like, you want to call it quits. slacking on the content. I know people always tell me, oh, take care of yourself and stuff, and I am, but there's just a line, because this is always happening. So it's like I can't just abandon what I want to do, my responsibilities, and things like that because of my joints. Because it's not like I just rest for today and tomorrow I'll feel better, right? A lot of people mean well when they say that, but given the reality, that's not how it is, which is okay. I appreciate the sentiment with it, for sure. But that's why right now I have to figure out how to do content while I'm sick. Talking more about my joints tomorrow and rheumatoid arthritis, just because it's kind of the only way I can make money. I guess just like making content that aligns with something.
Head in the clouds, but my gravity centered.
Thank you. just called Chevelle.
Okay, playing your Spotify playlist called Chevelle.
Focus on that. I'm grateful I could get gas. Oh my god. Watching my video. I'm just chilling. I'll have a vlog tomorrow. Talking more in depth about my health, but yeah. I don't really have anything exciting going on because literally every day I'm just stuck in bed. What else can I talk about, you know? Thank you. have a good one. Advertise that way. Like I said, I've been kind of like waiting on my being able to do new stuff to kind of load that up on my account, but I don't have that, and I know people still want to see my old stuff, so yeah, we'll do that. So I've been slacking on posting the old stuff anyway too. So like right now I'm trying to get out of this exit, and like people stop in front of the exit. Like, do people not follow that? Is that not a rule anymore? Like, people don't follow. Thank you. That lady let me through, though. It's like, I'm wondering, maybe I don't know. Are we supposed to still do that? Scooter's Coffee. Dave's Hot Chicken. It's all graffitied looking up. In a cool way, like, it's not real graffiti, it's like they hired someone to paint it, but it looked cool, like, spray painty, abstracty kind of look. Anywho, thanks for hanging out with me again, y'all. Nothing too eventful.
Thank you.
give Rhiannon away.